Kính chào quý vị. Đến với chương trình bản tin Hoa Thành Đốn hôm nay, Châu Duy kính mời quý vị theo dõi buổi phỏng vấn Thượng nghị sĩ Dave Marsden về chính sách giao thông, trẻ em phạm pháp và giáo dục do Kiều Thu thực hiện.
Kiều Thu xin kính chào quý vị. Mời quý vị đến với chương trình hôm nay với Thượng nghị sĩ Dave Marsden from quận 37 của tiểu bang Virginia, quận Fairfax. Và welcome, Senator Marsden.
Thank you, too. Yes.
I just told you that I am living in your district, in your mm-hmm. area. And today we will have a lot to ask you. Perhaps, you know, a lot of our audience also feel, who live in the same area with me, do feel that 66 is a nightmare. to travel on, and I understand that you're also concerned about solving the problem and working on transportation on Highway 66 and also Route 28. Can you tell us a little bit more detail about that?
Yes, we've written a letter to the governor about Interstate 66 to ask that we consider and construct a rapid bus system on Interstate 66. And what rapid bus will mean is there will be a dedicated lane that no cars could use, no high occupancy vehicles could use, buses only. There would be bus stops, much like subway stations, where people get on the bus at grade, at ground level, and could get on the bus and have Wi-Fi, and that the buses would travel at, you know, 55, 60 miles an hour. To be able to get and connect to the Beltway and get on the hot lanes on the Beltway and go to Tyson's Corner quickly. And these would start maybe in Gainesville in Prince William County.
Yes.
and move through, because it's a much less expensive alternative than continuing the subway, the metro rail, mm-hmm. Out to Gainesville. And we would have circulator buses that would get people to the parking lots, or they could drive to where they could pick up the rapid bus and get to Washington, get to Tyson's Corners, or get to the Springfield or Alexandria communities.
So this
via
is
the hot lanes.
Still a proposal.
This is a proposal a number of legislators in Northern Virginia have signed on to. It was an effort put together by Senator Peterson, Chap Peterson, in the 34th District. And a number of us agree that that's the best alternative to getting traffic moving on Interstate 66, is to give people alternatives, give people transit alternatives to driving their own cars.
Did that take away another lane?
No, this would be a lane that would be constructed.
Dedicated.
Dedicated lane that would be able to handle this traffic, and no one else could get on it.
I see.
And this is less expensive than rail, but we need to be quick because we need to make sure that we can get the right-of-ways necessary to do that before there's any more construction out in the western part of
everywhere construction. If we go in the morning, that we stuck with the rush hours traffic, and then if we wait a little bit for the traffic is less crowded, and then we stuck with the construction.
Yes.
And with all the construction going on in our area, how long do you think that could be over?
Well, I think the Beltway construction and the metro construction for Metro to Dulles, the rail to Dulles, should be done in 2013.
Two more years.
The first phase of the metro construction. Then there's a continuing phase from Reston to the airport, and I think one station beyond to Loudoun County. That will take a little longer, but we should have the hot lane construction done in 2013. But in the meantime, on Interstate 66. The Virginia Department of Transportation is repaving, and they're going to be turning Route 66 into what we call a smart road. This will be giving people information about how long it's going to take them. It's going to tell them, if you slow down and you reduce your speed to 40 miles an hour instead of going 60 miles an hour, it will give a traffic jam time to clear ahead of you instead of you becoming part of the problem.
I see some sign on 66 say 16 miles to Gainesville,
right.
how
mm-hmm.
long?
Yeah,
no, that's, it, is that
this will
effective?
Be a much more elaborate system. It will tell you to what lane might move you a little quicker,
uh-huh.
to move left, move right. It's going to provide a lot of information to you as to the traffic situation ahead of you, and so that you can make adjustments, and they'll suggest adjustments for you to make.
Instead of look at your palm
no, that
iPad
will be,
or your
no,
BlackBerry.
You'll see that on signs.
On signs.
On automated signs on
right.
the road. And so in a sense, what's going to happen is the road will talk to you.
Right.
And tell you what's going on.
How long that will take and how much does it cost? Will
well,
us
is,
have to
is,
pay for that?
Well, yes, ultimately the Virginia Department of Transportation will pay for it. And I'm not sure of the total cost, but it is in the... It is a reasonable cost.
Where do the state get the money
to fund the VDOT? Yeah, the state gets the money. Our transportation money comes primarily from a gas tax that we passed in 1986. That is 17.5 cents per gallon. The problem why we're so short of transportation money right now is that 26 years later, we're actually using fewer gallons than we did in 1986 because of fuel efficiency.
So less tax.
So we have
we collect
less taxes, and the 17.5 cents that we paid in 1986 that bought 17.5 cents worth of road construction or repair. Today that's only worth 7 cents because of inflation.
Inflation.
So we have very much fewer dollars. Very many fewer dollars to deal with transportation issues. Now this year...
But again, we want people to drive less or to consume less energy and
that's
take
correct.
Public
so that's good. So we need to come up with an alternative. And here's what happened last year in the General Assembly. Governor McDonald asked us, he said, if you will accelerate the bond package, 6 years of bonds for road construction, and you will accelerate it so we can use them all in 3 years, I will introduce... A funding formula fix for transportation in the upcoming General Assembly session that will take place this January. And so we said, okay, we'll do that. And so we're waiting to see what the governor does to fix our transportation funding problems here in Virginia. And so it was an agreement made with the General Assembly that if you accelerate the bonds so that we can spend them more quickly, the problem is if the governor does not come up with a fix, a funding formula fix this year, then we will run out of bond money in 3 years and there will be no further money for transportation. As a matter of fact, if this doesn't get done by 2017, it is now projected we will be a maintenance-only system. No new road construction, no road widening, no intersection improvements. All we can do is maintenance. Is do potholes, repaving, and bridge repair.
Hmm. You mentioned about Route 28.
Yes.
Might be the cause or part of the problem.
It's part of the problem. It is a problem that is.
What do you plan to do about that?
What has been asked. One of the delegates out there has asked to get the engineering work done. To devise a strategy for fixing the problems associated with the intersection of Route 28 and I-66. And one of the first problems you have is people trying to take a left turn onto Braddock Road. When they get off 66 onto Route 28, they have to immediately get over to the left
to get a dedicated turn
lane to be able to take a left on Braddock. And that slows people up, and then folks wanting to get on 28 within a mile, there's immediately a traffic light, and then less than a mile further on, there's a traffic light letting people in and out of a park. And so what we need to do in that part of 28 mm-hmm. is to have more of what we call separated grade intersections. Where there are no traffic lights, where people go under a bridge instead of having mm-hmm. to take a right or left turn, where people merge onto the highway instead of hitting a traffic light, and you've seen much of that take place on Route 28. Remember all the construction they've done at all the roads so that you don't have to get it, don't have to stop at a stoplight. And we need to do more of that on the Fairfax County Parkway. As a matter of fact, there's a very big project going on right now at Monument Drive, which is going to take away those two traffic lights and replace them with overpasses so that you don't have to slow down.
Okay. Thank you, Senator Marston. And I would like to take a short break so that we can introduce some news about our sponsors. I think we will come back in the next segment. So please don't leave the station. We'll be back shortly.
Thank you.
Thank you.